and welcome to another cabinet vision tutorial. My name is Tayla, and today we're going to be looking at answering a viewer question. The question is, how can we add an inner drawer inside of an existing drawer? So as you can see, I've set up a little part of a kitchen here where this might be a really applicable thing to know. In this kitchen, we've got nice deep tall drawer fronts all along this back wall. Gives this really beautiful sleek lines, it's a very modern look. But if we just imagine in this scenario, the client doesn't need this many deep drawers. Deep drawers are really good for storing pots and pans, but they're not so great for things like cutlery, utensils, even plates and crockery. We might want to add some more drawers in there so that they can get better use out of their storage. But if we split the drawers on the face, it's going to disrupt these nice clean lines that we've got. So inner drawers are a really good solution here. So let's jump over to the elevation. I'm going to show you how we can do it. So I'm going to just choose this bank on the left hand side. And first of all, I'm going to double click to get into the section view. So it's taking me to 3D, but I want to be in section. And then I'm going to go to section interior. I'm going to imagine that for this bank of drawers that I would like to keep a nice deep drawer at the bottom and just add in an inner drawer to this top section. So I'm just going to select a horizontal split, and that is going to throw in an adjustable shelf, and it's just chucked it right in the middle of the unit. But I want it to sit up here above the top drawer. So I'm going to make the height here just maybe 150 millimeters. So it sits above that drawer. And then I'm going to select the shelf, and on the left hand side here, I'm going to choose rollout tray. So basically, when a drawer is inside of a drawer, it's called a rollout in cabinet vision. I personally call it an inner drawer because that just makes more sense to me, but technically in cabinet vision, it's going to be called a rollout. So the rollout tray is an inner drawer. So let me just open up this unit so that you can see what I've done in the 3D. So I'm opening up the drawers pretty much all the way, and I'm just going to open the rollout or that inner drawer halfway. So I'm going to hit OK. And now if I go to my 3D, you can see there that in the bottom drawer, there's nothing above, nice deep space for those pots and pans. But in this top drawer, it's got an inner drawer that slides out on top of the bottom one. So they look the same from the front, but inside there's extra usable storage. So that is how to add in one inner drawer nice and simply. On the right hand side, I'm going to pretend that the client wants a set of four drawers, maybe for their cutlery, utensils, tea towels, that kind of stack of drawers. So again, double click to get into the section view. And then in section interior, I can click into the space. And this time I'm going to use the horizontal multi-split. And it's going to ask me how many openings. So always one more opening than the amount of drawers or shelves that you want. So I want two drawers, so I'm going to have three openings. And instead of choosing the adjustable shelf, I'm going to choose the rollouts straight away. So if I do that and hit OK, you can see that it's put in these two yellow sections, which are the rollout trays or the inner drawers, and then these blue sections are the open areas in between. So you can see these dashed boxes are basically representing the hardware that's attached to the face, so the proper front drawers. So you can see here that this inner drawer is going to be conflicting with that top face. We need to just fix the spacing a little bit. So I'm just going to click into this bottom open section and reduce the height. I'm just going to reduce it to 180. And then in this top section, I'm just going to make this top drawer a little bit closer to the top. I'm going to make that 50. Beautiful. So now if I hit return again, and then I just right click and open up those drawers and the rollout so we can see what we've done in our 3D. You can see that in this set, again, it looks the same from the front, two nice big deep drawers, But inside both of them, there's a rollout. So an inner drawer where you can basically pull the drawer, pull the secondary drawer, and have all that extra storage. So that's really simply how you can add in inner drawers or rollouts into your drawers in Cabinet Vision. If you have any further questions on this or on any other topics, please write them in the comments and we'll be glad to either answer them or to do a video on the topic. Thanks very much for watching.
Hey, thanks again for watching. And we're wrapped to announce that we're going to be launching soon an online learning platform that is going to help you learn and master Cabinet Vision at your very own pace. So if you'd like to learn more or sign up to be a beta tester and receive exclusive early access, please feel free to click on the link in the description below.